Victoria, and I'm a library assistant here at the Greenville County Library System. This is another video for Wacky Science. Today we're going to be doing an experiment from the book We Dare You by Vicki Cobb and Kathy Darling. This one is called Blowing a Chance, and you only need a very few simple materials. You need like a 2-liter bottle or even a milk jug, and you need a balloon. And so what we're going to do is fit the balloon inside the Coke bottle, and you're gonna pull the mouth of the balloon over the mouth of the Coke bottle and make sure that it's fully on there, alright? And you're gonna try to blow up the balloon while it's inside the Coke bottle. Sounds simple, right? Let's give it a shot. One more time. Okay. Can't do it. Unless you have amazingly strong lungs, like maybe you're Michael Phelps or something, but this is almost impossible for us to do because our lungs aren't strong enough to both blow up the balloon and work against the pressure of the gas trapped inside the bottle. So when we fitted the balloon over the bottle, we trapped gas inside of the bottle. So when you were blowing up a balloon, it's different than just blowing it up outside the bottle. We've trapped pressure inside the bottle, and when you're blowing it up, you are fighting against that force as well. Not just blowing up the balloon, but fighting against the force, the gas that's inside the bottle. So give it a try at home. Maybe your lungs are stronger than mine and you can do this. Yay! So this is the second part of the balloon experiment that we're doing today. This one is called Sunburn Balloons. It's from the book We Dare You by Vicki Cobb and Kathy Darling. You'll need another balloon, and you'll also need a magnifying glass. So we're gonna make this balloon blow up with the thermonuclear power from the sun. Sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? Okay, so what you're gonna do, I've made myself a little dot on the balloon with a Sharpie, because that gives me a target when I start to focus the sunlight on the balloon. That helps me. You don't have to do it. It is especially helpful if the sun isn't that bright during the day, during the time that you're doing this, because it might take a little longer. So it just having a circle to target helps you stay focused for the length of time it takes to blow up the balloon. Otherwise, like is going to be the case today, it happens so fast that it doesn't matter where you go. It's a matter of seconds before it blows up. Another thing, if you're not yet able to tie a knot in a balloon, totally cool. You can still blow it up. And then just twist it. And you can hold it like that and you're good to go. So don't let that stop you. Alright, here we go. Alright, so I'm gonna hold my magnifying glass and angle it. Woo! And it happens really quickly. Let's do it again. Okay, and I'm looking for that little pinpoint of light that my magnifying glass creates. It's really cool. Here we go. Oh my gosh. And if you want to try, be careful, because it heats up very quickly, but you can also see it on your hand too. It gets warm very quickly. So it's neat. The science behind it is just that we're focusing the energy of the sun on a very small point, and the balloon skin is thin enough that it immediately destroys the balloon. So thanks for joining us.